Shalom, guys. Welcome back to the reading of the book of Maccabees and understanding a little bit of the history of the Feast of Hanukkah. Right? So we're talking about the first book of Maccabees, chapter 2. It says, in those days, Mattathias, son of John, son of Simeon, a priest of the family of Horib, moved from Jerusalem and settled in Modein. He had five sons, John, surnamed Gadi, Simon, called Tassith, Judas, called Maccabeus, Eleazar called Abaran, and Jonathan called Afus. And he saw that the blasphemies being committed in Judah and Jerusalem and said, alas, why was I born to see this? The ruin of my people, the ruin of the holy city, and to live there when it was given over to the enemy, the sanctuary given over to aliens. Her temple has become like a person without honor. Her glorious vessels have been carried into exile. Her infants have been killed in her streets. Her youth by the sword of the foe. What nation has not inherited her places and has not seized her spoils? All her adornments has been taken away. No longer free, she has become a slave. And see, our holy place, our beauty, our glory have been laid waste. The Gentiles have profaned them. Why should we live any longer? Then Mattathias and his sons tore their clothes and put sackcloth and mourned greatly. The king's officers who were enforcing the apostasy came to the town of Modein to make them offer sacrifice. Many from Israel came to them, and Mattathias and his sons were assembled. Then the king's officers spoke to Mattathias as follows. You are a leader, honored and great in this town, and supported by sons and brothers. Now, the first to come, do that what the king commands. As all the Gentiles and the people of Judah and those are left in Jerusalem have done, then you and your sons will be numbered among the friends of the king, and you and your sons will be honored with silver and gold and many gifts. So Mattathias here is being asked to honor the king's command, right? The officers say that he is respectable, right? He's a man of honor, and so the people will see him obeying the king's command, and he'll make it easier for them to obey the king's command, and that he will be a friend of the king. But look at what Mattathias answers the officers. But Mattathias answered and said in loud voice, even if all the nations that live under the rule of the king obey him and have chosen to obey his commandments, every one of them abandoning the religion of their ancestors, right? The belief of their fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And I, my sons, and my brothers will continue to live by the covenant of our ancestors, right? Which is Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Far be it from us to desert the law and the ordinances. We will not obey the king's words by turning aside from our religion to the right hand or the left. When he had finished speaking these words, a Jew came forward in the sight of all the officers on the altar of Modein, according to the king's command. And when Mattathias saw it, he burned with zeal, and his heart was stirred. He gave vent to righteous anger. He ran and killed him on the altar. At the same time, he killed king's officers who was forcing them to sacrifice, and he tore down altars. Thus he burned the seal of the law, just as Phinehas did against Zimri, son of Salu. Then Mattathias cried out in the town with a loud voice, saying, let everyone who is zealous for the law and supports the covenant come out with me. Then he and his sons fled to the hills, left all they had in town. At the time, many who were seeking righteousness and justice went to the wilderness to live there. There their sons and their wives, their livestock, because trouble pressed heavily upon them. And it was reported to the king's officer, to the troops in Jerusalem, the city of David, that those who had rejected the king's command had gone down to the hiding places in the wilderness. Many pursued them and overtook them. They encamped opposite to them and prepared for battle against them on the Sabbath day. They said to them, enough of this. Come out and do what the king commands, and you will live. But they said, we will not come out, nor will do what the king commands and profane the Sabbath. Then the enemy quickly attacked them, but they did not answer them or hurl a stone at them or block up their hiding place, for they had said, let us all die in our innocence. Heaven and earth testify for us that you are killing us unjustly. So they attacked them on the Sabbath, and they died. Their wives and their children and livestock too, the number of 1,000 persons. When Mattathias and his friends learned of it, they mourned for them deeply, and all said to their neighbors, if we all do our kindred have done refuse to fight with the Gentiles for our lives and for our ordinances, they will quickly destroy us from earth. So they made this decision that day. Let us fight against anyone who comes to attack us on the Sabbath day, and let us not all die as our kindred died in their hiding places. Then there united with them a company of Hasidans, mighty warriors of Israel, all who offered themselves willingly to the law, and all who became fugitives to escape their troubles, joined them and reinforced them. They organized an army and struck down sinners in their anger and renegade in their wrath. The survivors fled to the Gentiles for safety, and Mattathias and his friends went around and tore down the altars. They forcibly circumcised all uncircumcised boys that they found within the borders of Israel. They hunted down the arrogant, and the works prospered in their hands. They rescued the law out of the hands of the Gentiles and kings, and they never let the sinner again gain the upper hand. Now the day drew near for Mattathias to die, and he said to his sons, arrogance and scorn have now become strong, and it is time to ruin the furious anger. Now, my children, show zeal for the law and give your livestock to the covenant of our ancestors. Remember the deeds of the ancestors which they did in their generations, and you will receive great honor and everlasting name. Was it not Abraham found faithful when tested, and was not reckoned to righteousness? Joseph, in the time of his distress, kept the commandment and became Lord of Egypt. Phinehas, our ancestor, because he was deeply zealous, received the covenant of everlasting priesthood. Joshua, because he fulfilled the command, became judge in Israel. Caleb, because he testified in assembly, received an inheritance in the land. David, because he was merciful, inherited the throne of the king forever. Elijah, because of great zeal for the law, was taken up into heaven. Hananiah, Azariah, Mishael believed and were saved from flame. Daniel, because of his innocence, was delivered and from the mouth of lions. And so observed from generation to generation, that none of those who put their trust in him will lack strength. Do not fear the words of the sinners, for their splendor will turn into dung and worms. Today they will exalt, but tomorrow they will not be found, because they will have returned to the dust, and their plans will have perished. My children, be curious and grow strong in the land and the law, for by it you will gain honor. Here is your brother Simeon, who I know is wise in counsel. Always listen to him, and he shall be your father. Judea, or Judas Maccabeus, has been a mighty warrior from his youth. He shall command the army for you and fight the battle against the people. You shall rally around all who observe the law and avenge the wrong done to your people. Pay back the Gentiles in full and obey the commands of the law. Then he blessed them, and he was gathered to his ancestors. He died in 146th year. He was buried in the tomb of his ancestor at Modein, and all Israel mourned for him in great lamentation. So here we see that Mattathias, before he passed, he remembered or reminded his sons of what being faithful and truthful to Elohim brings, which is protection, honor, and salvation. Mattathias gave to their sons words of wisdom. Stay true to Elohim, stay true to his word and his covenant and laws, and protect it with zealously. Thanks for watching. Shalom.